America has suffered some shocking incidents of gun violence over the years. In the last year, the Navy Yard shooting and the Sandy Hook Elementary massacre have fueled fresh calls for gun control. But one author says there's a good historical reason not to create new gun laws. Stephen Hallberg of the Independent Institute explains it all in his new book, Gun Control in the Third Reich. CBN recently spoke with him concerning about the book.
Stephen, it might seem extreme to use the Nazi regime to examine gun control laws. What sparked your interest in the topic?
What really sparked my interest was back in 1968, there were bills in Congress to register all firearms, and Congressman John Dingell said, well, you know, the war just ended 23 years ago, and this sounds like some kind of control of the type that the National Socialists had. And it was denied by the proponents of this legislation that the Nazis ever disarmed anybody or that they used registration records or blacklists or whatever, which was nonsense. But about 15 years ago, I began seriously to do research into archives in Germany. And it's just an untold history of how gun control was basically created in the Weimar Republic era. And registration records on all law-abiding gun owners were created, and then those records were later used when the National Socialists came to power to disarm first the political opponents of the Nazi regime and then the Jewish people.
What did your historical research reveal about the dangers of gun control laws?
Well, you heard back in the 20s, they were making the same debates pro and con as you hear today. Those proposing licensing and registration of law-abiding gun owners thought that would do something about all the violence that was being committed, which was mostly political violence in Germany at that time. But they warned, do not let the registration records fall into the wrong hands. The opponents of that kind of legislation said that only law-abiding people will abide by this, so it won't do any good, basically. And then, sure enough, when in 1933 Hitler came to power, the records fell into the wrong hands because they immediately started to disarm all of their political opponents. That would be members of the Social Democrat Party or the Centrist Party, the opponents.
Would a better armed populace actually have made a difference against such an evil totalitarian regime?
They've put great emphasis on disarming any opponent or anybody they wanted to victimize. So we have to conclude that there could have been resistance of some kind. I'm not saying that the Holocaust would have never happened, but I am saying that things would have been could have been different in individual cases, or there could have been resistance by groups. The problem, and what's so different, we have a Bill of Rights, we have the Second Amendment, we have a long tradition of constitutional guarantees in this country, and they didn't have that in Germany at the time. And the way the Nazis operated was to go after one group after another and do it separately so that people don't unite against them.
Would you suggest that this could happen in America?
I think it would be a great exaggeration to compare Nazi Germany to America today. We enjoy free elections, a free press, and the right to keep and bear arms. We're kind of like in the same as in the Weimar Republic. We have to be careful what kind of legislation we adopt so that something doesn't happen. But I think I agree with the concept of American exceptionalism, and I don't think we're anywhere near that horrible historical experience. But we do have to learn from history.
Indeed. Stephen Hallberg is a research fellow at the Independent Institute and author of Gun Control in the Third Reich. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me, Efren. Enjoyed it.